one of every 10 space launches in the world fails. Resulting in losses worth hundreds of millions of dollars, sometimes even including the deaths of expert astronauts and cosmonauts. Spectators who gathered to witness the launch of these massive spacecrafts end up witnessing a massive firework in the sky worth millions. Space agencies who've cheerfully prepared for the launch for years get engulfed by a wave of sorrow and disappointment. And a $1 billion project vanishes into dust in a matter of seconds. I'm here to show you some of the worst and most terrifying rocket launches and failure incidents ever to happen. Let's begin. Number 10. Antares. On October 28, 2014, the tried release of an Antares carrying a Cygnus shipment spacecraft failed drastically 6 seconds after liftoff from spaceport at Wallops Flight Facility, Virginia. An explosion took place inside the thrust port just as it took off, and it, unfortunately, crashed back down onto the launch pad. The renovated NK-33 engines, being over 4 decades old, were suspected of leaks, corrosion, or manufacturing errors that weren't detected. Number 9. Alcantara. In 2003, Brazil had high hopes of becoming a space nation. The country is placed on the equator, and the rotation of the Earth gives the rocket extra lift. But in August, 3 days before the scheduled launch by the Brazilian Space Agency, a massive explosion rocked the city of Alcantara. At the spaceport, a huge cloud of black smoke rose from the position where VLS-1 solid fuel rocket once was erected. The sudden blast killed 21 people and injured a lot more. Number 8. Challenger.
On its 10th launch on January 28, 1986, the Space Shuttle Challenger exploded 73 seconds after launch. All 7 crew members died and completely capsized NASA's space program's reputation.
The launch was delayed. Everything seemed fine until the craft exited Max-Q, a period of maximum aerodynamic pressure. Mission Control told SCOBY, Challenger, turn up the gas, and seconds later the aircraft disappeared after exploding at an altitude of approximate 14,000 meters, 46,000 feet, merely just 73 seconds after takeoff.
Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
All the communications between... 1 minute into flight.
1 minute 15 seconds. Number 7. Juno 2.
On August 15, 1959, the next Juno 2 flew with a Beacon satellite.
The performance of the first stage was nominal, but the higher stages did not perform well. The intended experiment on this mission was the ejection of 4 of its flares, stored in the interstage section. But things got worse when the flare release didn't go as planned. The control system also malfunctioned, pushing the upper stage out of orbit into the Atlantic Ocean instead of the orbit. Number 6. Titan 1.
On August 14, 1959, the first attempt to fly a Lot B rocket with a live stage and dummy warhead failed.
The missile launched 3.9 seconds ahead of schedule before it gained sufficient thrust to lift off. One of the core umbilicals ruptured prematurely upon launch of the missile, another umbilical sent an auto-shutdown command, and Titan returned to the pad and exploded, killing all hopes, and heavily damaging the LC-19 launch pad. Number 5. Atlas 1957.
On June 11, 1957, Atlas made its maiden voyage.
The engine started fine and the launcher release system worked perfectly. Everything was smooth until T plus 26 seconds when the B-2 engine lost its thrust, followed by his B-1 engine 2 seconds after it. Atlas reached its maximum altitude of 3,000 meters, 9,800 feet, and tumbled through its own exhaust path until T plus 50 seconds when security officers sent an order to self-destruct. Number 4. Falcon 9. A giant fireball erupted from the company's main launch pad at Cape Canaveral Air Force Base during pre-launch testing on September 1st. The Falcon rocket and satellite were destroyed and the pad got cracks. 2 days before the scheduled launch, the ground crew refueled the Falcon and gave the engine a brief test start. The blast shook the launch pad and buildings miles away at NASA's adjacent Kennedy Space Center. The sound of the explosion continued for several minutes, and black smoke rose into the morning sky. Number 3. Atlas Centaur 5.
The Atlas Centaur AC-5 was launched at 8 a.m. on March 2, 1965.
Within about a second of launch, the thrust of the Atlas booster engines rapidly decreased. The vehicle retreated to the launch pad and was quickly destroyed by fire and exploded drastically. The launch facility and associated equipment were severely damaged. The loss of thrust in the booster engine was due to starvation of fuel at the turbopump inlet due to the fuel pilot valve or stage valve closure, resulting in serious damages. Number 2. Vostochny Cosmodrome. In 1960, the Soviet Union, locked in a space race with the United States, was developing an intercontinental ballistic missile known as the R-16, and on October 24 that year, a prototype was planned to launch, but the mission failed horribly. The mishap occurred as the first and second stages of a Russian booster rocket separated shortly after the launch from Kazakhstan's Soviet-era Cosmodrome of Baikonur. People died in horrific pain, essentially burning alive, but the country and the rest of the world practically never learned anything about that terrible catastrophe and its heroes' victims, Russian space agency Roscosmos said. Fortunately, the two Russian men's crew landed safely.
Everything is on fire. We don't know how many wounded there will be. Get ready. The call to the military hospital in Mirny came about half an hour after the disaster.
Number 1. Proton-M. In July 2013, the Proton-M/DM-03 carrying three GLONASS satellites failed shortly after launch. The booster began to tilt left and right along the vertical axis within seconds of launch. Attempts by the onboard supercomputer to correct the course failed, ultimately leading to an irreparable disaster. The upper stage and payload were stripped apart due to the forces incoming 24 seconds after the launch, followed by the first stage breaking and catching fire. A collision with the ground occurred 30 seconds after liftoff. Reports from a July 2013 failure investigation showed that three of the first stage sensors responsible for control had been improperly oriented. Well, that was it, and I hope these accidents don't repeat, and no more casualties take place. Subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.